What's up, everybody? This is Jay, and this video is about Power Season 6, Episode 11, Steel Drake. Now, this is the first of the final five episodes of the Power Saga, and I'm going to break it on down. But before I do, if you haven't already, please subscribe and bang that bell so you're notified of all my videos that I upload. I really appreciate your support. And also, hit that like button. Let's get into it. Now, we first kick off the episode. We see Dre, and he's sitting there singing his little song to his baby girl, trying to sound good. And then his baby mama saying, Dre, what's going on? We need to get up out of here. What's all this about? We need to go and move, be with my sister. And he said, no, my organization is at the top. I'm not doing that. And while he see that, he see on the news that Ghost about to run for lieutenant governor, and that just messed up his whole day. He thought he was on top of the game for a minute. So now he goes to see Dirty Ballsacks, and he's like, hey, look, man, what's going on? You told me to trust you, and you was going to take care of Ghost, and he's running on TV for lieutenant governor. He said, hold up, let me wake up. Let me, stop smelling like baloney for a minute, and let me check into this. Tate ain't doing nothing. He said, no, it's Lorette Walsh. He said, what? Okay, I'm going to just trust me. He said, look, I ain't trusting you for nothing. I got my own back. So now we see he's with his organization, and he's introducing a new member of his crew, OZ. He like, yeah, I just got out for good behavior. He like, man, you ain't never been good or nothing. And Waka Flocka said, hey, look, man, what's up with all that? Forget that reunion. Where's that product you promised? And he said, I'm not messing with the Serbians. We gotta wait. And then he said, Dre, we're not messing with you. You killing the boss. Now, you guys don't have to die today. We only want Dre. And Dre said, look, man, I don't trust them. They gonna kill you soon as you put your guns down, y'all. And they said, all we want is Dre. He kill our boss. He's a backstabber. We want to get him. And so Dre still telling him, hey, look, man, I ain't do that. I ain't kill him, man. And said, while he's sitting there going back and forth with, Jason Left Hand Man, we see Dre knew best buddy, bosom buddy, end up pulling the trigger and kicking off the little war. And so he pops one of their men. Next thing you know, everybody's shooting, is going back and forth. It's just like a little menage a trois violence going on. And so everybody taking cover. Dre men getting killed, the Serbians getting killed. OZ, he done emptied out his little clip or whatever, Slim 50 Cent. He like, man, I miss this stuff, man. We see Waka Flocka, he end up getting shot over there on the side. Dre, half his crew is almost dead now. It's only him and OZ now left damn near. And so when OZ was shooting, taking out one of the other dudes, he ended up catching a bullet. And so now Dre really know he in trouble. And so he started making his way out of there. One of the dudes got a chopper, and so he got to start shooting or whatever. And then while they was getting out of there, Dre's trying to, protect his boy and get the hell out of there shooting. And then next thing you know, dude come with the Chicago typewriter and just unload. And Dre, when he see him coming, he ends up being just as dirty as always, and pulls his boy in front and used him as a human shield. And so he got chopped up by the chopper from old boy. Dre just used him as, cover. And next thing you know, he pops up and takes dude out. And so Dre, he ends up getting out of there almost without a problem, but he gets shot in the shoulder, and he ends up still letting off a couple shots or whatever and escaping out through the back door and getting the hell out of there. So later we see him with his girl, and she like, what happened, Dre? I told you. And he said, look, some things went sideways. I wasn't expecting that. She like, well, who shot you? He like, I don't know which one shot me. She like, look, this is it. I'm getting out of here. He said, but we can run New York. He said, I'm taking heaven and I'm out. He said, nobody is taking heaven from me. And his nose got enraged with anger on swole, and she got scared. And she said, well, come with us then. We can leave. We can get out of here. And so he thought about it. He said, all right, forget it. Come on. We'll get out of here. I just got to, get a couple things together. She said, what about the money you got? He said, man, everything went sideways. Some stuff was lost. She said, well, you know what you got to do. You know who you gotta see? He said, hell no, I ain't never going back there again. I ain't never seeing that. She said, she just gave him the look. And so then he kind of thought about it. Meanwhile, we see Urkel and Jerkel, and they getting questioned by J-Lo. And she's saying, what's going on? And he say, look, man, I know how does it feel to be questioning people look like you. I know it ain't your fault. She say, oh, you an enlightened motherfucker. He say, oh, okay. And then we got Urkel, and she say, so you got two strikes. You know, you got third strike, you out. He said, look, she said, you was assault. He said, look, man, that dude was twice my size, okay? Yeah, he came at me, I hit him with a bottle. She said, well, what about this theft? He said, I did that. So now she asking Jerkel, and he's like, look, she said, all you guys are, you know, predictable. He said, well, then you should know what I'm about to say. Meanwhile, she going back and forth with Jerkel. She said, you a little guy with one tough friend. What you gonna do when your friend get transferred, huh? He's like, you gonna be able to handle that? Then we see Jerkel, and she's back and forth talking with him. He like, look, I ain't got nothing to say. I don't know nothing. She said, oh, okay, what about Tommy Egan? You been here having his back, but how many times he have your back? He said, Tommy who? And she said, oh, okay, you know who it is. And then she's saying the same thing to Urkel. And she said, man, what's up with Tommy? He like, man, I always had that crazy ass dude back. She said, yeah, but how many times has he crazy ass dude had your back? Now, you really want to go to jail for life for Tommy Egan? You a three strike offender. He said, look, all I know is looking to the death of a street dealer named Poncho. And she's like, oh, okay. And so now you what you gonna do? You gonna go down for Tommy Egan? He said, look, all I got to say is, since I'm predictable, is you know what's next, lawyer. Okay. And so right when he was saying that, Urkel, he pretty much then became a little rat on Tommy. Now, we cut back to Dre, and he's sitting there leaning on the corner like Boys to Men, and then next thing you know, we see this old lady come out, so he run up on her, and she like, ah, I don't have no money, but you can have whatever I had. He like, mama, it's me. And she like, Andre? He said, yeah, mama, it's me, I'm back. She said, boy, what you doing here? He said, look, I came to see you. She said, came to see, what's going on? He like, look, she said, you got out of prison, you didn't even call me. Now you running up on me. What's going on, Andre? He said, look, I didn't want to see you when I knew things wasn't right. And she says, oh, is that right, Andre? You could have did so much better. You had so much potential. You could have been somebody to be proud of. And now you out here running the streets and stuff. He said, no, mama, I'm making a change. I'm about to get out of New York. And me and my girl, we gonna leave. And my daughter, a daughter? So you come run up on me and you say all this stuff about some daughter and some that I never seen before and expect me to give you some money? Are you crazy? And then she just walk off and he just looking stupid. Meanwhile, since plan didn't work, he pulls up on Tasha's daycare and he like, ain't it supposed to be babies running around? She said, look, you need to go. He said, no, I need to talk to you about something important, your son's future. She said, what are you talking about? And he said, yeah, I know Tariq been moving major weight now, and if you don't want me to have to go and say nothing, I'm gonna need some money. And she says, oh, well, the only reason you know you think I'm stupid is because you the one that gave him that brick, and if you say something, you'd be telling on yourself. He said, yeah, well, I got that brick from your husband, okay? Now, I'm not playing. I need this right here, or else we gonna have to, I'm gonna have to go and start talking. And she said, look, Andre, I don't have any money. All my money is wrapped up in this, and I got an empty daycare. He said, I don't give a damn. You need to talk to your son. He real resourceful, and you need to make sure he call me, or else it'll be problems. And then he walk off, and now she's salty. So now we see him, and he blowing little dungeon dragon smoke through his nose, and next thing you know, he's smoking on his bliggity blunt, and Tariq walk up, and so while he puffing on the bliggity, Tariq give him a little bag and a little money, and so he start counting. They like, man, that brick was worth twice as much as that. 20 G's. This is only half that. He say, look, man, it was short notice. I came up with the best I could. What's up, man? Give me a little more time. I got you. He said, okay. He say, I also need another favor from you. He like, what? So now you want some more stuff from me? He said, look, man, I just need to get an untraceable weapon right here so I can go handle something. He said, who you trying to kill? He said, man, I ain't telling you that. And so Dre said, look, yeah, okay, you know how it is. It ain't nothing for free. You want something from me? Then I need access to somebody only you can get me. He said, I'm not messing with ghosts no more. He said, look, I don't give a damn. He said, he probably shoot you on sight. He said, not when I'm with you. Damn about your daddy issues. That's what I need from you. Now go ahead and make that happen. All right, and so now we see that's how that meeting came with Dre and Tariq. And so Tariq walks in at Truth, and he got Dre with him, and Ghost like, what are you bringing him for? He's our enemy. He said, what is this, Tariq? And he said, I need, he said he'd tell, and he know all this information about me, and if I didn't bring him, he'd tell, he'd snitch. And so he said, go wait outside, Tariq. I'll talk to your little friend. And so he said, what are you doing here, Dre? And he says, man, first of all, take that bass out your voice. I got some information that about your son. Now, I know you wondering why I'm not locked up and everything, and I know you killed Jason and tried to set me up with that murder. He like, Jason's dead? I didn't know that. He said, yeah, right. Anyway, if you don't want me to talk, then I'm gonna need some money. He said, well, look, I got 250 large for you. He said, man, what? You think you gonna lowball me with your son's future hanging in the balance? He said, look, that's what I have, Dre, and I'm gonna have to meet up with you. But you know what? I'm disappointed in you, Dre, because you had all the potential and you ended up just being a wannabe gangster. That's all, you know. And he says, look, man, keep all that. I ain't trying to hear that. He said, I'm gonna save your ass one more time. He said, you ain't saving me, you saving yourself. He said, all right, well, I'm gonna give you the call to meet up, get you this money. And so Dre leave. Meanwhile, Urkel and Jerko is in pen, and they wonder what happened. How'd they get there? And they like, man, Urkel was saying, Tommy set us up, man. Why else, man? We saw him there watching. He said, man, that don't make sense. And why would Tommy burn us and his own warehouse? He said, Urkel said, man, everything he was doing didn't make sense. He ain't trust nobody. And I say, you can't trust nobody that don't trust others. And then he said, who else knew about all this? And then Jerko said, man, I know who else that knew about the warehouse and everything. It was Dre. And he's like, that snitch. Meanwhile, we see Dre making another stop when Tank just kicked somebody out the office. And he like, look, Dre, as you can see, I'm fine. He said, well, look, I got some information for you, man, and I need your help. He said, I need a new ID and plates. He said, what make you think I could get you that? He said, look, I know you got connections. You helped me get my daughter back, which I'm thankful for. Plus, I got information about James St. Patrick that you may be of use. He said, what is that? He said, his son is about to be taken in for the murder of Raymond Jones. He said, how you know? Because I'm the one that told him. Meanwhile, we see Dre, and he waiting at the spot Ghost told him to get the money, and he on the phone. Now we know he was talking to his girl on the phone, and he's saying, yeah, baby, I've got 250 coming. She like, damn, that's a lot of money. How you get that? He said, man, Ghost think he's smart, man, but I know his little play, man. I know he ain't as smart as he think he is, so I'm about to get this, and we out. And when he get off the phone, police swarm up on him. Next thing you know, he is in the 211 hemmed up, and, you know, it's all over for him. His heart just melted like ice cream in the microwave because he thought he was about to get a clean getaway with the loot. Meanwhile, we see Irk and Jerk, and they sitting there trying to figure out what's going on, and then the police call Francis, so he laughing at the name Francis. Then he say, Spotswood, and so, he just sitting there quiet, so he like, Spotswood. And so he look and get up, and he Francis like, man, Spotswood? He like, yeah, man, I'm named after a judge, look it up, man. And so next thing you know, they go ahead and get called off. Then they're in the next scene, they in the orange jumpsuit. And so he like, man, this ain't good too, man. Orange ain't my color. I ain't trying to do no fed time. He said, man, would you shut up, man? All time is the same, man. It don't matter, long as you know how to operate. And next thing you know, this phone gets slipped in by the guard, and that's when we see them get the phone. He like, who that? He like, how the hell am I supposed to know who that is, Irk? I'm about to find out. And he get the phone call, and next thing you know, we see his ghost. He like, hey, man, you still got my watch? He like, oh, okay. What's up, man? Your boy, he put us in here? He said, oh, no, that wasn't my boy. That was your day one. And he said, okay. And so that's when he knew it was Drake. And so he like, so what's up? He said, hey, look, you go ahead. He's about to be in there. You go ahead and handle him, take him out, and I'll make sure that your family is straight for the time you in there. He like, oh, yeah, though, that might be a long time. He said, that's all right. They don't need to do time with you. He said, what about my boy? If he help me, he said, if he help you, then I take care of him. He tell Urkel, hey, man, we got a job to do. He say, Francis? He said, hey, Spotswood. Trust me. So meanwhile, we see they come out and they see Dre in there. And so now Dre worried. He see these dudes got the little shank in motion. You about to have more holes in him than homework that was chewed up by your dog. And so now he's worried. He sees Spank got the back covered. And so now he's trying to think of a plan because he smells danger. And so the next thing you know, he sees the two-bit squeezes the nose, which is like death symbol to Dre. So Dre get up and he start talking to this one dude, calling him Big C, and dude like, man, I ain't no Big C and I don't know you, man. And right before anything kick off, the guards calls Dre, and so by the, you know, skin of his nose, he escapes that possible death sentence. And so when he leave, Irk tell him, hey man, you better breathe slow, your next breaths may be your last. And so he give him something to sit on while he leave up out of there. And so Irk and Jerk didn't get to hit him yet. Meanwhile, we see J-Lo, Blanca, and she like, though, what happened? What you doing? And he say, I can't help you. You're going to go to jail for life for killing Jason. And he say, look, man, I didn't do that. She say, well, I don't know what to do unless. He say, unless what? Unless you can answer the question. Did Jason Patry tell you he killed Terry Silva? He said, no. He ain't tell me. I saw it. She said, you was there? He said, yeah, I was there. She said, oh, yeah? He said, I was at his place. You mean the parking garage? He said, yeah. And you saw him yoke him? You saw him yoke him? He said, yeah, I saw him choke that dude. And I told him to stop, but he wouldn't. You would say all of these on this time? He said, yeah, I say this wherever you want me to say it. He said, okay. Well, let me call it the judge, and I'm going to see what I can do and maybe get you out of here. He said, well, you need to hurry up and get me out of here, because if it ain't by today, my memory get a little fuzzy. And so then she walk away, knowing that time is of the essence. Meanwhile, Irk and Jerk is like, man, this is some bull, man. We supposed to get him. He like, just be patient, man. We could be back. And then next thing you know, they see Dre walking out of there in street clothes. He said, man, does it look like he about to be back? He said, man, how the hell he get out so soon? And Jerk will say, man, the only way you get out that fast is if you snitch. He said, man, that freaking snitch. So now we see Jerkle, he on the phone, he like, man, it's the only play. And so he called Tommy, he like, man, Tommy didn't know about what went wrong last time. And so he telling Tommy, hey man, what's up? He like, hey man, where you at? You how I know you in the can still? He said, man, you can look it up, I ain't no soldier. He said, well man, I don't know, I can't trust none of y'all right now. He said, well look, the dude to set us up is out free. He like, I thought you handled that. He say, man, I thought it was BG. I can't find him nowhere. He said, well, BG's dead. He like, BG's dead? Hey, look. He said, he killed him. He said, well, I can't trust none of you all right now. Plus, somebody in the organization told him about Poncho. I'm out. And so then he get off the phone, and 2-Bit say he ain't with it. But 2-Bit kind of suspecting Urkel told about Poncho. Meanwhile, we see Dre, and he's riding with the feds, and so he's trying to figure out a way out of there. And so he like, hey look man, I gotta pee. And they like, yeah, well, we almost at the spot, you're gonna have to wait. He like, man, I don't care, I might go ahead and pee in here, is this leather? So they end up deciding they're gonna go ahead and pull over. And so now he like, hey look man, I know they don't pay you enough to watch, man, I'm just about to go around here, work this water hose, and I'll be done in a minute. And so while he going over there to pee, next thing you know, he bails out and leaves out of there. And so now we see him picking up some little spare rock with a key in the bottom. And so he's breaking into somebody's home, go right upstairs, goes right where he need to go. And next thing you know, he sees this old lady jewelry box. And so he's in there taking the little old lady jewelry box. And next thing you know, you hear click clack, and then we see it's his mama with a gun. gun pointed at him. She said, I knew I couldn't trust you. I knew it. I just knew you was bad. I don't know why the Lord blessed me with such an evil, rotten child. He like, Mama, why you say that? You've been calling me that ever since I was 6 years old for stealing the candy bar. That's what you did to me. Every day you told me I was evil. I was nothing. Every single day of my life. What you thought was going to happen to me. Like you say, judge not, for you will be judged. Condemn not, for you will be condemned. Forgive not. And then he take the gun from her, and he pointed at her. Now she's scared. He said, but I will never forgive you for what you did. And he was about to squeeze the trigger, but he couldn't bring himself to it. And so he ends up dropping the gun on the floor and leaving. And so then she break down crying or whatever. And so she's sad or whatever. And so, you know, it just showed Dre was really something else. He had a could have been good, but who knows. And so he gets in the car with his girl and give her the jewelry box. She said, what's this? And he said, look, that's all she had. And he had little tears in his eyes. He trying not to get him to roll down his nose, and he pulls off. Meanwhile, he gets into Tate's office, and he like, hey man, you got the stuff I need? He's like, yeah, my brother, I do, but I got something else you gonna need since you want to get out of town. And then he sprinkle a little dough all on the table. He like, that's 100 G's. He like, man, what you need me to do? He like, I need you to kill James St. Patrick. He like, what? He said, yeah, I need you to do it by tonight. Now we both know this ain't something out of your character, good brother. He said, yeah, but he ain't no corner boy. He says, I know. That's why I got a lot of money on this table. So he says he's going to go run for the campaign trail, and I can't have that. And so what's it going to be? And he says, all right, I'll do it. And so he reached for the money, and he says, hold on now, brother. Half now and half later. And Dre, he says, look, man, I need that money now, okay? You want me to do the job? I do the job. But we both know that you ain't gonna wanna have no connections to me. So if you go ahead, give me the money, I'm gonna take care of it. And that's my word, okay? And then his nose is just inflamed with seriousness. And Tate kinda looking at it, he like, woo, man, that's good. I like how you lean into that. But we both know your word ain't worth a damn, dude, don't we? But you know what? I'm going to go ahead and give you this money. And you know why? Because I'm the only one that knows about your new identity and your license plate number. And if you end up, you know, screwing me, then everybody will be looking for you. He said, you ain't got to worry because you just paid me to do something I would do for free. And so then he hops in the car and he tells his girl, hey, look, I got this right here from you. She like, really? And so then she looks, she like, where'd you get all this money? He like, Tate need me to do something for him. And so now they happy. They think they gonna be able to stay together like an old school relationship. But then he pulls around and turns. She like, what you doing? You don't have to do this. We could leave. Tate can't tell on you because he'd be burning himself. And Dre just keeps going anyway. And so he gets out the car, and next thing you know, he getting his gun cocked and he ready to go. And so inside a troop, and so once he goes in, he hears a gunshot. He turns around, and right when he comes out, he sees J-Lo, and she like, Dre. And then he gives her a right hand sucker punch and knocks her out with a one hitter quitter. And so he leaves, bails out worried, goes straight to the car, and she like, what's wrong? And so he worried and forehead rolled up like old newspaper, because the plan didn't go how he wanted it. And while he's arguing with her, he sees Tommy on the corner. And so while he trying to get a better look at what's going on with Tommy, this car rolls by. He loses, you know, sight with Tommy, and the light changes, so they pull off. So instead of having a full tank of gas when they left, because that's too much like right, he had to stop at the gas station, and he's getting a can of pop, and he's getting a little teddy bear or something for his daughter. And so while he's sitting there lollygagging, wasting time, he sees on the news that James St. Patrick was slain in the nightclub. They saying he was murdered. So now he's happy, he's feeling real good, and he's thinking that everything is all right and that he's going to get away with everything. And next thing you know, girl was no longer all smiles. She worried. She's looking ahead. head, she tell him to run, and now we see he's surrounded, police everywhere, and now he's screwed. He going to jail for escape from the feds, and he done punched J-Lo, and they gonna nail him for what he did with Jason. His little baby girl is watching. He knows he's in trouble, nose all swole up like a baby toe been soaked in water too long. And so now we see he's getting his mug shots. They getting him processed into the pen. He coming in trying to be on Swoliosis. They got him bent over like he was at a pride parade. And so now Dre, he don't know what to do now. He's screwed. He try to walk in looking harder than sheetrock, knowing he's softer than baby shit. And so once he gets processed, he's sitting in the pen. He thinking about what's gonna happen. While they thinking, they calling me in for visitors. His girl like, I told you we should have left, Dre. And she's saying, look man, you think I don't know that? I ain't trying to go through all that right now. She said, so what we gonna do? He said, man, we need to get a lawyer. She said, I need help. I had to ask somebody for help. Don't be mad. He like, what you do? Who you ask? What are you talking about? Next thing you know, here come his mama walking in all high and mighty like her farts don't stink. And so she said, Dre, I'm gonna be here for them. I'm gonna take care of them. They asked me for help, but the judge didn't give you any bail, so it really didn't matter. And so I'm gonna be here. He said, why you come? Well, it was the Christian thing to do, Dre. I'm trying to be here for them, and I'll make sure that she grows up the right way. And so here's somebody to talk to you. And so she hands the phone and to his daughter. She say, hi daddy. He say, hey baby girl, daddy messed up. His forehead wrinkled up like old homework. He say, I gotta get one thing right, and that's being with you. I'll be there. I'm sorry, baby. And so they get off the phone. They go ahead and walk off. And now Dre's sitting there stuck on stupid all alone. Meanwhile, Urkel and Jerkel are sitting there talking about what they need to do. And then next thing you know, he hops up. Christmas just came early because he sees Dre walked in. So he know he about to go ahead and get that handle. And then Dre sees them. So now he know he's screwed. And so first thing he do is go take this essay's pudding. He like, what you doing with my pudding, huh? He said, I don't even like vanilla. He said, you the messed up, man. And then he steals on Dre. They fighting. He beating the hell out of Dre. And Dre tried to make him look like the newest member of the Sap of the Month Club, and he wasn't having it. And so now they take Dre. He said, you just got a week in the box. And so they put Dre in the box. He's sitting there, lip just as swole as his nose. And next thing you know, we see these towels, and they soak because you can hear him hit the floor. And so Dre like, hey, man, what y'all doing? What's up? And then he like, hey. And then we see Urkel. He like, hey, what's up? Did I do that? And he like, hey man, Spank, what's up, man? He like, hey man, you about to be one crispy ass Negro. And he says, man, what you doing, man? Come on, we boys. And then we see Jerkel, and he's like, hey man, come on, too. We grew up together. We boys, man. What you doing, man? Well, don't do this, man. You ain't got to do this. He like, man, this is a message from Ghost. He like, man, Ghost is dead. I saw it on the news. You ain't got to do nothing for him. He like, that money was just a bonus. Next thing you know, Urkel sprays this little douche bottle full of this little fluid, look like alcohol or something. He like, man, why you douching me, man? He like, hey, look, man, we about to take care of you, man. What happened with Brock? And he's like, he was boys too. And then he turned on the little flame. He like, come on, man, don't do that, man. Don't do it. And he throw the flame inside the room. Next thing you know, everything caught on fire. And it just spread like wildfire. And too bad he watching it as Dre is sitting there burning like a $2 hole in church on Easter Sunday. And so they just watch him barbecue. And so then they just see, we see the end of Dre, and his schnoz is all but a memory. The schnaga is all complete, and they just close the damn door, put some little tiles up under the door to make sure all that stuff stay in there. This is a hot box. They walk off, and then they just go ahead and act like they ain't seen or heard nothing. So meanwhile, we see 2-Bit, and he's sitting in his cell. And then when they open it up for them to move around, he goes to check on Spank. And so he like, damn, where's Urkel at? And the guards say, man, he got out of here, man. He must have a better lawyer than you. And so right then, he put two and two together and realized that he the one that snitched. So he go in his room and call Tommy. He like, man, I know who snitched on Pancho. He ain't in here with me no more. Meanwhile, we see Urkel, and he's sitting there talking with J-Lo. He like, damn, mommy, your man did that? If your man did that, you don't need to be with him. She said, look at here, I don't have no man. And it was your friend Andre Coleman who did this. He said, that ain't my boy. And now that I know he hit women, I ain't really got nothing to do with it. She said, yeah, you all were there together because of the paper with me. So do you know what happened to him? Do you have anything to do with he did? He said, no, I ain't had nothing to do with that. And he ain't my boy. And so she said, okay, well, here, this is the paperwork. He said, Tommy not going to find out. She said, no. He ain't gonna do no nothing. He don't worry. And he say, what about your boy? He said, what's up with 2-Bit? She say, oh well, he gonna do the same thing unless he smarten up and talk. He say, oh, he ain't gonna talk. He a real G. And she say, what that made you? He say, huh, free man. And while she leave out, he see her talking with Paz, and so he didn't know because he had no translator what they was talking about, but it did look kind of suspect, making us believe maybe that's what the next episode is all about. Now it's time for some real talk, a lot of people's favorite part of the video. Now first off, I did like this episode, and I gotta give Dre Rotimi a lot of credit because he pulled this whole episode off as the lead damn good. It seems to show that it's a waste that now he's dead, because he may have been able to carry off the next spinoff better than maybe Tariq. But who knows, because now he's dead, the saga is complete. Now a couple things about this episode, because this episode you really didn't even miss Ghost. It was kind of crazy. I hope he isn't dead like the news said, but we'll have to see. They could have been doing that to protect him because he seemed to be a victim or a target. Also, one thing that I saw in this episode, Dre should have killed Tate. If he would have killed Tate, he would have been able to get away with the money and the identity, didn't have to go to Truth, and he would be home free. But instead, he honored Tate and tried to do that mission. And then he should have killed J-Lo when he was there and saw her, because he should have known that the first thing she was going to do once she saw the ghost was dead, which, or shot, is try to pin it on him. And he punched her, which is assault on a police officer and a woman. So she was definitely going to be on his ass for that. And he betrayed her. And, you know, he was also bogus for using his best buddy as a bulletproof vest. It just shows that Dre has no compass of morals, don't give a damn, he didn't care about nothing. And also, why did he steal from his mama when he had that 10 G's from Tariq? He stole her little costume jewelry for no reason. That was kind of crazy. Dre don't give a damn, boy. But in the end, it was a good show episode. The conversation between him and Ghost was a little different than the way Ghost had it in his episode, so which conversation was correct? It leads me to wonder. In the end, I think this was a very good episode, actually. And I hate that the show is ending, and I hate that Dre is actually dead now, because he could have actually had more potential doing other things in this show if he was still alive. But it is what it is. I'm Jay. That's Real Talk. I want to thank y'all for being patient with me. For those who follow my channel and follow me on social media, you know I've been out of town for a while. I'm back. I got this video. I tried to bring it to you as fast as possible. I want to thank everybody that support my work at patreon.com/JMoreReviews. Everybody to follow me on social media, I appreciate you all. I'm out. Time for me to get back in the lab, crank out these videos for you all. Peace, and I'll see you on the next one.